Chester, Pennsylvania, to move to beautiful Bradford County about 23 years ago. We're in Leroy Township of Bradford County. Been self-employed for 22 years, been successful in a plumbing and HVAC business, which in 2008, when the economy crashed, that business was dying. We happened to have a one-truck oil company when the gas industry showed up and started doing service calls to repair, you know, rig housing and portable housing on rig sites. And through doing that, they started us having to deliver oil, which we grew. Now, that oil company had one truck and one driver. We started delivering fuel for the gas industry. As that oil company grew and the HVAC business was dying, a lot of other construction companies around, it supported other jobs. It retained jobs that I would have laid people off that worked for me for 20 plus years, some of these people. They were with me from the beginning, and we didn't want to let them go. So we started delivering oil. We used the profits from the oil company to support the plumbing and heating business, what never happened in the first 20 years of being in business. So that oil company continued to grow. We had a convenience store, which was basically a small mom-and-pop convenience store, which continued to grow. We added a truck filling station to it, which created more jobs. We since then have sold the convenience store because it grew with everything else, and it was too much to manage for me and my wife.
Okay, you get it.
So we continued to grow that oil company to the point where it delivered every 14 days, but it took us an entire year. So I personally have benefited from financially, as well as employees. We created jobs. Jobs got better paying. I mean, you took a truck driver who was making $13, $14 an hour to $21, $22, give him 10 to 15 hours of overtime. Quality of life has gone down for some people. I'm not discrediting some of the things that were mentioned tonight. Some of them are over exaggerations. But the industry has taken a lot of people around here that if they were not here, we'd be in an economic disaster. And I understand the economy, and I learned a whole lot more about the economy as it was dying. Because good business people who had loans, when the work shuts off, and you expect you're going to get X amount of work a year, you can't pay your bills. And fortunately, I didn't have that problem, but I know contractors here that struggled, lost their credit, lost their houses, and they were good contractors. It just happened to be the wrong time. So we grew that oil company. We since then have sold that because it grew beyond, again, our ability to run it for the amount that the growth and the jobs it created, and managing 47 people. I mean, we had about 13. We went to 47, and it became too much for me individually. But again, it created jobs. We took some over-the-road truck drivers who had to run out of town, who wanted to be home with their families. Well, now they're home with their families every night. And so there's another positive thing. A lot of guys around here that drove truck were over the road. They leave for a week or two, and they come back and see their family because there wasn't the job sustained here. You know, I know some farmers personally that if the gas industry didn't show up, they wouldn't own their farm. I know farmers that have sold their gas and oil rights because they were able to keep the surface. Now, people might think that's a bad thing, but would you rather own the surface of your land that your family's had and not own the gas and oil rights, which really we never knew we had what we had here, so they were able to keep the surface? So, you know, it's not all doom and gloom here. The other thing is that the $4 natural gas that was mentioned has helped this nation's economy, because if gas was at $12, $13, $14, $15 per 1,000 cubic feet, on the other end of these lines, there's a lot of families that would be devastated and lost their homes because their utility bills are literally one-third the cost of what they were in 2008. It's driven the cost of living down in this country. People don't understand it. You look at the other end, there's literally millions and millions of people on the distribution lines at the other end of this gas line. So it's not all doom and gloom. This is good for the national economy. When it comes to jobs, when the industry first showed up, you can't take unskilled labor. We were unskilled in the oil field. They let us do what they felt was safe for us to do. I've been in many safety. One of the reasons I sold the oil company was because I had a fear that if we had an accident or a spill, we get fired. Because they're, on this end of the safety meetings, we see there is a no tolerance, and you educate your competitor, again, for safety. They don't want accidents. They don't want spills. Unfortunately, we have humans working this industry, and there's problems. This isn't a perfect industry. I'm not here to stand in front of anybody. This is not perfect. There's some of these issues are true issues that people have. There's no denying it, but it's not the end of the world. I'm going to, one last thing. Canton Borough, I talked to the borough manager for the Water and Sewer Authority today. They have paid over $1 million worth of loans off. They were 40-year PennVest loans. 4 years into it, they paid over $1 million in loans off because they had sold enough extra water. They had enough capacity, sold extra water. They reduced the utilities, the water service bills, to the borough of Canton. And that's a fact. I got that information tonight. I didn't know they did a bill reduction. They are continuing to save the money that they have gotten from Chesapeake and these other gas companies, and they're going to upgrade infrastructure with probably no loan. So there's a lot of positive things. It's not all doom and gloom. There's definitely things that need to be changed. But we got to look at the other end. Everybody's worried about this liquefaction. It will probably take 10 years to get a liquefaction plan online here if we ever do export gas. There is talks of that. A lot of people don't know that they've canceled the Alaskan National Gas Pipeline Project. It was to bring natural gas from the lower, from Alaska to the lower 48, because shale gas in the lower 48 is going to sustain this country for 100 plus years. And they're talking about liquefying the natural gas in Alaska to ship that in other parts of the world. I've done a lot of research. There's no doubt a lot of other people in this room have done a lot of research. But there is definitely a lot of positives to this. There's negatives. There's no doubt there's negatives to this. I mean, traffic is bad. I mean, let's face it. We don't like traffic. I moved from a metropolitan area where you can sit for hours to get from one job to the next. And we see, you know, half hour traffic, and we don't like it. We're a rural community. That's why I moved here personally. But unfortunately, we're going to have to adapt, because really this isn't just about everybody here. This is a national security project.
Okay, thank you very much, Dave.